I'll write it down. I'll just make you understand what all possibilities are there. Okay, then because outputs are not there, but still we can do it on the router. So implement the command. Okay, same thing. Now you have to make a queue. Right, just give me a second. So first, see here what we are going to do, we'll make same queue, but for this I'm queuing for voice, for your HTTP and for FTP. Okay. So access list, I need a space. Access list 100, permit UDP, any range of your voice port will be like as we discussed 16.38.32.32.76.7. Okay, and then same thing, access list will create 101 or make it 102. Permit TCP, any equal to 21. Access list 104. Permit, again this is TCP, any. Sorry, this is your port number 80. I'll go it across. Now port number 21, accordingly will go FTP. Okay, so these are my three traffic. Okay, now what we will going to do is, we're going to class, we'll create a class map. So class map called voice. Okay, and we'll say match access group 100. Okay, come out of this, exit. After that, class map called your web match access group 101. Okay, and exit. Similar way, create a class map called FTP, and call here. I will type 102 match access group 104 and exit. Right, so we defined our three class map. These are my three queues. Okay, after that, we create a policy. Policy map queue, we'll give a name called queue. Okay, now class called voice. Okay, let me change the color. Voice class called voice, and this I will going to give priority of 80. Now priority means, now this command I was telling yesterday, I am telling you, priority means LLQ is enabled, and this is 80 kbps of bandwidth. You have to specify enter. Okay, one option is this, another option also I will write another. Now second is, we'll type exit here, then we'll type class called web. Now here this is CBWFQ, so we have to type bandwidth. Suppose I'll give 64. Okay, and exit. After that, class called FTP, and here again I will give a bandwidth 128. Now these are like three queues you made, one called VoIP, one called web, one called FTP. What about the other traffic? Other traffic, I'll put exit here. Other traffic will going to sit in a default queue, class called class default, and we'll give bandwidth, suppose anything, bandwidth 32. It's up to you what you want to assign. Now this is one command. I'll let you know, this is like, I'll just put it across here. We have one more thing, I'll put or here and this side. So I'll put it here. See, either you can give priority this 80%, 64 kbps, 80 kbps, 128 kbps, 32 kbps. Denote in kbps, or for every all your command you can give percentage also. Percentage of what? See, this 80 kbps, 70 kbps, see, whatever in the tx ring. Suppose in the tx ring you have for example, I will say it is 100 Mbps. So when I am telling you that these queues are taking you this much bandwidth, 32 of 100, 128 kbps of 100 Mbps, 64 kbps of 100 Mbps, okay, your 80 kbps of 100 Mbps. So it is connected to your this TX ring bandwidth, your egress bandwidth. That much bandwidth I am taking for this individual queue. One is with these numbering, I am giving the ranking, which will be processed first. Plus, I am giving minimum bandwidth they will going to get this. Otherwise, see, in few, like when you learn VoIP calls, minimum bandwidth we need 80 kbps. So we have to assign that. Otherwise, there those that call quality won't be good. So that minimum quality, like bandwidth, we have to assign per protocol. So that all up to the requirement. Okay, either you can give 80 kbps concept, or you can give like percent command is there. Suppose I will write here priority percent 10, meaning 10% of 100 Mbps. Here also bandwidth percent 30, or you can write percent suppose 30. Suppose 30% of this. Here also bandwidth, you can give percent command, percent whatever you want to put 40. Here also bandwidth percent 10. 10% of 100 Mbps. Either given kbps or given percent, it's up to you, but make it, it doesn't mean that one will be kbps, one will be percentage, one will be kbps, one will be percentage. No, all should be on the percentage or in a kbps. Now few more things are there, I'll let you know, which will could be a new stuff for you. Now you always, you have to remember, like when I was teaching you marking, I said 6 and 7 is reserved for your OSPF, all control messages, all control. I'll put all. I won't write OSPF and all those things. Oh, everything, RIP, OSPF, EIGRP, VTP and everything. Likewise, when it comes to the bandwidth, okay, suppose your interface bandwidth is 100 Mbps. Out of that, 75% bandwidth is used for data traffic. And 25% is reserved for control traffic. Whenever you are getting any packet, any control packet, TCP handshake or OSPF update, RIP update, any update, for that at least 25% of bandwidth I have reserved for this. So meaning what we are doing, we are playing with only 75%, meaning it is not 100 Mbps what we divided. We divided 75%. We have a command, you can change this 25% to 5%, you can change it to 0, you can change it to anything, numbering is given. So we can manipulate this and then you can give it to data traffic. Suppose in the service provider side, you are running BGP, so we have to give. But in the internal networks, when we are running only static route or any OSPF, then no need to give 25%, reduce the bandwidth for control traffic. All depend. Okay, so two things you need to understand. For data traffic, 75% of whatever bandwidth, if I'm telling you, you have 128 kbps of link. Now out of this, calculate 75% is reserved for data, 25% is reserved for control. That calculation, it will do it in the backend. Clear? So to change, now next I will tell you how to change. Other part is you created these policies. Okay, now you have to call it under interface. So go to the interface, anything. I said F0/1. You went. Okay, now service policy outbound. This concept is outbound straight away. One option you can see for input also, inbound, but it won't work. This concept is outbound concept. And then you have to call the policy map name, Q. Okay, and then again, always, I'll put it across, always on egress interface, that's why outbound. This is the configuration of your queuing. We'll do it on the router also, so that I'll show you this option. And suppose if you want to reduce that control traffic percentage, what you have to do is go to the interface. I'm inside the interface, right? I'm just changing the color for this. I'll change the color and I'll show you. Now this is for control traffic percentage. Now maximum reserved bandwidth. Now this command is actually for what is the reserved bandwidth for data traffic. What I will going to do is I will make it 95%. So meaning now for users, now okay, this is for users. Now for data traffic it's 95%, but for your system, meaning control messages, then that will be only 5%. So you can play around with this command. Okay, you want to make a note, you can make a note, because again writing all these things are good. I'll give you like 5 minutes, just make a note. Then I will show you, because concept these are little important. Okay, so I'll show you now the practical same. So outputs are not there, but you show command, I'll let you know. But these are real time things, right? We'll make one topology, but I will configure only one router, because suppose this is your access layer, distribution layer, core layer. Okay, so your access layer, distribution layer, core layer. So either you can apply this or you can apply on this side, right? So I'm doing on the this particular enter. Or what we can do is we'll put a switch here and I'll connect this interface also. So step by step, I'll do it on F0/1. Okay, I'll do it here. Commands are important, very, very important. Configure terminal. Okay, so we'll configure interface F0/1. No shut, just any IP address we will give. IP address N.1.1.1. Start the configuration. Access list 100, permit UDP any range 16383232767, I think. Yes. And then access list 102, we set permit TCP any equal to 8. Access list 104, permit, sorry, permit TCP any equal to 21. Okay, so once this is done, so class map called voice, match access group called 100 and exit. Class map called web, match access group called 102, enter. Exit, match class map called your FTP. Match access group called 10. We have created the class map And now we will going to create the policy map. Policy map called Q. A class called void. Voids I have taken. And if I go to question mark, two things we need to use here. Bandwidth command, it won't be written anywhere. CVWF, you need to understand that priority. Strict scheduling, meaning LLQ, if it is empty, then only it will go out. So they gave a strict scheduling. So hereby I will put priority. Priority 80. This you have to remember. Okay, one more thing. Put a question mark, two things. In KBPS or in the bandwidth percentage. Either you type it in this or in that. Okay. So I'll give 80 KBPS. Okay. Or I should have typed a percent command. It's up to you what you have typed. I have shown you both. Then class called web. And I will give a bandwidth command. Bandwidth 64, and we'll make it more like 80 kbps. 80 kbps again. Okay. And then class called FTP. Bandwidth I will give 128 and then we have one called what about other queues are like other traffic will go in this queue. Class called class default, which is already made. Okay, here you can set bandwidth to percent sorry anything 10 kbps. But then you can even change the, you can also apply fair queue concept. If you remember fair queue, more than 2 Mbps, before less than 2 Mbps fair queue. So for that it should be less than, it will automatically take, but we'll go with the bandwidth command we have given already. Okay, it's up to you. You can give fair queue, it will take 2 Mbps or less than that. No need to then assign. Or I gave CVWF queue, it is up to you. So that's it. That's it. So I'll show you show history. This is what we did and what we discussed also. Okay. And then go to interface F0/1 service policy output and name is Q. Okay. So if you want to check also show policy map interface, what interface we applied this policy on F01. So whatever policy match all this, you will, it's a strict priority queuing. Okay, 80% bandwidth. So whatever configuration you have given, you can verify from here. Okay, one more command I'll show you. Show interface, let me check if it is given there or not. Not. Available bandwidth 72. Like 75% when I have told you, when they calculate, somehow I gave you the approximate figure, but it is saying that available bandwidth is for my data traffic is 720 whatever kilobytes. So that is according to the percentage of 100 Mbps is doing, whatever is the actual bandwidth. So now I will going to modify this. So we'll just going to see whether it reflect or not. Max reservation bandwidth, I'll make it 95. Okay, we need to check show F0/1. This time if you will notice, it is changed to 9202. Right? So you can control your data bandwidth and control bandwidth also. Okay. So this is your practical for queuing. Now another important topic which is little difficult, very much too many calculations are there, so that is called traffic shaping. Topic is called traffic shaping. Okay, and side. With that also, I will explain you because these both topic goes hand in hand. Traffic policing. So now always remember, as we discussed also, basic of QS, traffic shaping will be done on the customer side. I'll say customer edge, right? And you do policing where? On the provider edge. So, and this concept is what you are doing. You are reducing the, here you are doing something called traffic shaping. So you are reducing the TX ring, not the software buffer, hardware buffer. You are reducing TX ring. Simple. Okay. Now try to understand, suppose this is your overall 100 Mbps. Okay. You reduced to 10 Mbps. As I have explained you, they won't play with your speed. So again, I will clear that concept. Like if suppose if you will going to check the command, it will be like this. Speed is 100 Mbps. Bandwidth is 100 Mbps. So what they change, not the speed, but the bandwidth. Okay. So this speed will be your is traveling speed. Okay, this is how much it will carry per second. How much data? Bandwidth means how much data it will carry per second. So there is a difference, right? So now other part I have explained you, when now bandwidth will reduce to 10 Mbps. So what, how much you carry data will reduce. With your, when your, how much data you carry will reduce, meaning with respect to TCP, just recall your windowing concept, your window size will decrease. When you will recall your windowing concept before, like, suppose your window size was 10, means when you see that data rate, how with what data rate you are downloading a particular file, okay, that depend on your TCP window. When you are going for a good internet connection, 100 Mbps, then it is much faster. When suppose you reduce to 10 Mbps, what will happen? It affect here data. When they do calculation, data rate will go down because your window size will reduce. Before you are sending 10 segment per second, now 5 or 2 segment per transaction. So that eventually will going to reduce your internet speed also. So we said that speed is slow. Normally we use this terminology, speed is slow, but speed is same, your bandwidth is less. So eventually you will get less packets. Clear? So now What they do, they do shaping at your end. It did 10 Mbps. Now what is policing? Now policing, they have to do it on the provider edge router. And this is your, I have told you, in and outbound both concept. Inbound, outbound, both. Right? Now they are making sure that you won't send them more than 10 Mbps. If suppose packet is coming more than 10 Mbps, I will drop it. Okay. If suppose here any configuration difference will be there, more packet will drop and retransmissions will increase. Okay. If retransmission with data retransmission will increase, then load will be more. So that's why these two configuration, whatever shaping you decide, according to that you have to decide the policing also. Okay, if suppose I will give you a basic difference between what is shaping and policing, I'll make a note, then maybe you can understand properly. Give me one second. I'll put it across here somewhere, blank space. This is traffic shaping. This is your traffic policing. Traffic policing is also called rate limiting. Okay, so shaping is excessive data is buffer. Now I'll let you know the meaning. Excessive data in buffer. It will go in buffer. Here, shape policing will be excessive data is dropped. Excessive data is dropped. So first I will explain you the meaning. But I'll change the color also. Okay. Meaning is, see, your inbound is 100 Mbps, outbound is 10, you reduce to 10. Now when excessive data will come from inbound, okay, from your ingress, what will happen? That data, every data won't go out, it will be buffered in the software queue. That's why we have learned the concept of queuing. Right? That's why they are mentioning excessive data will be in buffer. Whereas in traffic policing, excessive data, if more than 10 Mbps you will send, it will be dropped. So that you have to understand in shaping. Shaping is a concept you apply on the egress. This concept you apply on the ingress and egress both. Plus, policing has one more functionality. Policing can remark your marking. He can play with your marking. It could be a possibility, whatever mark you are typing, he can do remarking. In policing, we have a command that it can do remarking also. I'll let you know how. Okay, that I will explain you. But right now, first we have to understand what actually is shaping. So first of all, I will tell you one concept. This you need to understand a little bit mathematical. Without shaping concept, how traffic will go from your scheduler to TX ring. Okay, how data will go out. So this is your without shaping. Normal. Okay, like if someone will ask you a flow, you can explain you. We have few terminologies called TIR, which is called target information rate. Okay, which is, suppose my interface bandwidth is overall is 100 Mbps. So that's what I'm saying without shaping. I have not shaped it. This is 100 Mbps. Terminologies you need to understand, then I'll make a graph. We have something called TC. This is called token interval. So I'll combine, first of all, let me write all these terminologies. Token interval for Ethernet is by default 25 milliseconds. This is for Ethernet. Suppose it is frame relay, it could be like 125 milliseconds because those are slow egress interface. So here it is default. Then you have something called BC, sustained burst. So in sustained burst, this is like actually a bucket size. I will put it across. It is also called size of a bucket. I'll make a note later. What are buckets and all those things, I'll let you know. So formula is for sustained burst is PIR into TC upon 1000. Whatever is the calculation will come, that will be your size of a bucket. Here data actually go in buckets. They made a bucket. Okay, and then how many buckets? Next question is how many buckets? This is size of a bucket. So if suppose you do the calculation, it will come 2.5 MB per second. Per bucket can handle 2.5 MB with respect to this calculation, suppose. Other part is how many number of slots, number of buckets. Number of buckets or slots. That formula is your 1 second upon TC. TC is 25, so 1 second series. TC is 25 milliseconds. I have to convert this 1 second into millisecond, it will become this, and that will be a number of slot which will come 40 approximately. Okay, now I have all the information above. I'll going to utilize it and I'll let you know how data goes from scheduler to the TX ring. This is the suppose now speed is 100 Mbps. How much data is coming? That is the bandwidth here, 100 Mbps, 100 MB per second. Now they are saying how many buckets you have? 40 buckets. So I will place suppose 40 buckets, whatever how many I can make a note, I'll just draw it here. Suppose these are like 40 buckets. Okay, now they are telling you that what is the size of each bucket. Each bucket can hold 2.5 MB of data. 2.5 MB of data, 2.5 MB of data. So 40 into 2.5, it will become 100 Mbps. Okay, and then like when a packet arrives, first bucket will be filled. What is the time difference between first and the second bucket? That time interval is 25 milliseconds. Okay, so this is called TC, 25 milliseconds. Size of bucket is 2.5 MB. And how many buckets overall? 40 buckets. This is without shaping. I have done nothing called shaping right now. This we can teach in NA also, like how packets flow. Now, try to understand. How much now scheduler is understood that like he will go into process accordingly, because like logical buckets will be created. So suppose first packet is coming 2.5 MB, it will sit here. Okay, there could be a possibility within this much seconds only. I cannot wait for 25, like it is like within 15 milliseconds bucket filled, but I have to wait for 25 milliseconds. Okay. And then another stream will come. Now it could see, now possibilities you can see. There could be a possibility scheduler can send 1.5 MB. Then sit here. Meaning what you are doing underuse. You are not utilizing your complete buffer. There could be one possibility, like it send you 3 MB data. If it is sending you 3 MB, again try to understand, it will drop the packet because he's saying my exact size is 2.5 MB. Doesn't mean that I will accept 2.5 and drop 0.5. No, 3 MB is not allowed, so dropped. Okay, it could be underused, drop, or there could be like sometime processing issue. Processor is little bit slow, a complete interval is skipped. So you are not utilizing the bucket. I'm just giving you all the possibilities. Or other will go by 2.5, 2.5, 2.5. Now always try to understand whenever, suppose you check your bandwidth also. Okay. Normally it won't show you like 100 Mbps. It is like when you do testing also, normally I'm saying it will be little less. The reason is this. They cannot explain you all the reason, because now it could be a, these are all possibilities. I cannot tell you when this happened, when that will happen. Okay, these are all possibilities what they have given. It could happen, underuse, dropped, or because of slow processing, you are not using anything. You're not utilizing your bucket only, because once 25 milliseconds is over, jump to second buffer, jump to second. So within this span of time, I have to send this my data. So it could be underuse, or meaning you are using, suppose here 90 Mbps or 89 Mbps, whatever. So this is your concept without shaping. Now I hope so. Same example, one more example I will repeat now. That will be with shaping now. Now when you will shape, what will happen? Okay, then policing will also come in the picture. Here what you will do policing, because you cannot do 100 Mbps. Or like more, he won't send you more than 100 Mbps. When policing is required, that I will let you know. Okay, once I will clear this. Now, another concept you need to understand once this is done, this is called with shaping. Try to understand same concept, but just I am shaping your network. So what service provider has done, okay, the internet connection guys, so whatever they do traffic shaping. Here your target information rate will be 10 Mbps. So TIR, it is in the command, it is written CIR, committed information rate. Actually, they upgraded this terminology to TIR, but in the command, it is still showing committed information rate. So what you did, you reduced your bandwidth. This is your reduced bandwidth. Okay, and then you have something called TC that will remain 25 milliseconds. This is your interval between two buckets. Okay, then here you have something called BC, which is called size of a bucket, sustain burst. In sustain burst, same formula, TIR into TC upon 1000. This will become your size of bucket. And then extra thing is, like, try to understand, you are reducing 100 Mbps to 10 Mbps. So maybe when you go for internet connection, they will tell you that 10 Mbps is your connection, but maximum you will get 12 Mbps. Like in some interval of time, you will get 12 Mbps. I'll tell you the reason. That is called maximum burst. Just explain you that concept. That is called VE. Maximum burst. So it will be like your PIR minus TIR into TC upon 1000. Now this is your second bucket size. You have two buckets here. This is your first bucket size. This is your second bucket size. Now what is this? This is actually called PIR, peak information rate, which they are giving. Maximum you will get 12 Mbps. Now actually, why they give this kind of thing, that 10 Mbps is your actual, but you can get more than 10, also 12 Mbps at certain peak hours. Okay, so reason I'll let you know now. See, first of all, when I have explained you without shaping concept, why there was no PIR. Now try to understand, your actual bandwidth is 100 Mbps. How come a second bucket will be there? What I did here, I'm reducing 100 to 10. So 90 Mbps is still left. So what I'm making a partial second bucket also. Okay, but why we are doing in the real time, I'll just let you know. See, suppose your first bucket size is, suppose 1 MB. Second bucket size is 0.5 MB, right? So number of, I'll write it here, number of slots will be like, you will calculate whatever is the number of slot that will be there. According to that, formula is 1 second upon a TC. TC is remain that, so 40. Okay, so overall you'll make 40, two buckets, 40. Meaning like this. Here you have one big bucket, one small bucket. One big bucket, one small bucket. One big bucket, one small bucket. One big bucket, one small bucket, right? Now interval between these buckets are 25 milliseconds. This capacity is 1 MB. His capacity is 0.5 MB. Okay, now speed will remain 100 Mbps. Now here policing will make some sense. You send me more than 10 Mbps, I will drop it. Suppose. But here we have something called 12 Mbps concept also. So they make it 12 only. But I will give you separately the policing configuration. Okay, just the configuration we have to show you what actually configure after shaping. Now try to understand. These are the like intervals. Now there could be a possibility, okay, he's sending 1 MB data sitting here. And then 0.5 MB is also coming. We're gonna try to understand what you did. You are reducing the bandwidth, but time interval is same. So packet can process little faster. For that reason, second bucket is there. So 1 MB is coming sitting here, 0.5 MB will come sit here. Fine, this is like an exact match. Okay, fine, when you're doing perfectly processing. Now things goes wrong, like suppose you are sending 1 MB and then after that you have not used. So second bucket you didn't use, underuse. There could be a possibility you are not sending anything. So not at all used. There could be a possibility you are sending a 2 MB data. So 2 MB means straight away drop it, because he can accommodate 1 MB and 1.5. So either send separately, not like in a one shot. So these are like a possibility. Now, why they made two buffers? They are making two buffer again and telling you so that at least you will get 10 Mbps of bandwidth, what they are telling you. There could be a like few, like sometime only that you will going to send 12 Mbps. If you are sending 12 Mbps, fine, they will accept, because in the positioning they are saying that if you will send more than 12 Mbps, then only I will drop. But if it's between 12 Mbps, okay, I will going to accept. So now reason is because of these small thing, any drop, it doesn't mean that you'll get overall 12 Mbps exactly. You will at least, they are trying that whatever they are telling you, see there is like two offers. One, they understood that you will get happy with 12 Mbps. Okay, you are getting something extra. But then you do not know that at you are getting this 12 because at least you will get 10. That is their strategy. Okay, so at least whenever you check the bandwidth, it should be 10. And again, I have told you, like whatever bandwidth you are, we are playing here with TX ring bandwidth, we are reducing 10% and all those things. That is like what you are playing with the queuing. 10% of this, 20% of this is this. Okay. So these are the possibilities of your shaping. That's why we have two buckets, because we have space. Okay. So now with this, shaping is done, but immediately I'll tell you the queuing also. There is one configuration, like with that respect, I will tell you that what actually they do. See, when they are giving, you have given TIR and PIR, how they play around. Like I have one configuration. Okay, just you'll get an idea. They can do whatever, like depend on the whatever their requirement, whatever they are looking with this, that particular customer, they are going to put that particular thing. Okay. So we'll take one example of traffic policing. So under traffic policing, actually, suppose I will say that your CIR, which is also called TIR, is suppose 128 kbps. And then your PIR, they are saying that maximum you can use 256 kbps. Okay, not an issue. Now what in traffic policing side, they are putting a condition. Now they have to put a condition actually. There's nothing like to understand, just the conditions. So one condition I'm explaining you, suppose CIR. If CIR allow CIR, if it is less than equal to CIR, sorry. Allow this particular packet, if it is, allow it, if it is less than equal to CIR, which is 128. If it is equal to or less than, you are allowed to send. Other condition is, if suppose packet is greater than CIR or TIR but less than PIR, try to understand the condition. They are saying that if suppose it is between 129 to 256 or less than that, okay, what you will do? Allow. Condition will be allow, but if suppose you are using more bandwidth, what they can do? They can change your mark to 2, precedence to 2. See this? They can totally, you can play around with you. So they can decrease your priority. Normally we don't do, but still they have that policing and do remarking also. So greater than CIR and less than PIR. Is allowed, but change the precedence to 2. Change precedence to 2. Okay, and if it is more than, greater than PIR, drop the packet. Greater than PIR, drop it. Okay, so these are like one of the conditions you can put in policing. You are rate limiting. Okay, it's up to you. So we'll do these two configuration. First, I will quickly show you shaping and then policing. So it's easy actually, but first of all, I write it down so that you'll understand. Then I will give you one configuration where we will going to combine your shaping and queuing. But later on, let me explain you this. First of all, traffic shaping. Now, again, because shaping you are doing for all traffic, always remember all traffic. When anything you are defining for all traffic, do not create class map. Call your class called class default. This default class map is already created. This means for all the traffic, because policing and shaping is for all the traffic. Okay, we cannot go like, we do it for everything. So policy map straight away will create policy map shape. Why I have not created your class map? Because it is for all the traffic. Then you have to call here class called class default. Class called class default. Okay. And then type this command called shapping average. It is given in like kbps, I think, so you have to type it accordingly, whatever 10 mbps into kbps, whatever digits will be there, so that conversion you will do it. Okay, so and then exit. Even if suppose you want to do a peak information rate, so here only first of all shape peak, suppose you want to make it 12 mbps, suppose this is a command. Okay, and then exit shaping and policing, you sorry, your TI, this is your TIR, this is your PIR. Okay, and then exit and go to interface F0/1 and type service policy output shape. Service policy output shape. Okay, so this is your one of the commands. So I'll just quickly run this command and I will show you on the router already is configured. I'll configure on this router. Configure terminal. You have to create. Okay, I'll make it. Just for. So policy map. Sorry. Shape. Okay, class called class default. Okay, shaping average. If I put a question mark, it is given in bits per second, or you can give percentage also, like how much you want to shape. Suppose I want 10%, 10. Okay, and shaping. Shape peak. You want to give suppose whatever like accordingly, or you can give properly percent 12. Okay, so for example, then go to interface F0/1 service policy output. We made shape right shape. This is how you reduce the bandwidth of your router when actual bandwidth. The other under interface, again I will let you know that I was that day I was explaining you. This command is for traffic engineering. This command does not reduce your actual bandwidth. This is just manipulate the routes metric. Okay. Now similar way, I will write it down. That will be the last part of your policing now. Okay, so how to write down that policing? I will just make it on R3. So configuration is for policing, same thing what condition I gave you, policy map called limit, right? So inside this you will going to call class called class default, because I am doing for everything complete default. So we use when it is for all traffic. Okay, I'll just make a note. When you are revising, it will be good. We'll use when it is for all the traffic. Okay. So remember this. And then you have to type police. Now this command is a little different. Police. Here they have given CIR, not TIR. That I have told you in the command, they will give CIR. You want 128 Kbps, so 128. Because this is, I think, is in, I'll take the, this is in bit per second. Okay, so Kbps, not even Kbps, so 128, 123 Kbps. Okay, and your PIR is 256 Kbps. Okay, so what we will do, confirm action transmit, meaning this means if it is equivalent to CIR or less than CIR, transmit. Okay, exceed action, if suppose it is more than CIR but less than TIR, okay, set, see this, precedence. The question mark, see this. I will say, do you want to make it anything? Four. That is up to you. Enter. Okay, and then violate action what? Drop the packet. Means if it is more than PIR, it will drop. Okay, so I will put a question mark and exit to show history. This is what command is. And go to interface, any interface you want to go, wherever it is hitting to the inbound. Okay, service policy, I will say input limit. Okay, so this is your configuration for shaping and policing. One more configuration I let you know, so then tomorrow we can do the last topic for your QS, that will be your congestion avoidance. So let me complete, we have time today. So see, in the real time you need to understand, when I am telling you, try to understand the scenario first. You are saying on this customer edge, on this egress, two things can be applied, queuing or I'll say and shaping. Traffic shaping. But if you notice right now, for queuing and shaping, I am making a policy map. Okay, both applied on outbound direction, and I can apply only one policy map. Try to understand, I can apply only one policy map. If one I will apply for queue, second I'm trying to apply for shaping, it will be override. That concept is clear, it will be override. Then what to do? So I'm just writing down the configuration which you can write in a production network, because one second. So how actually it works, so that you have to understand. Okay. So we'll say shaping. And queuing. This configuration is important. Just first of all, I'll make a configuration for queue. So I'll make, suppose, class map called web. Suppose we have wrote access list also. So I'm not writing those access lists now, you have understood, but the main thing where the things will go change there, what that what I will mention. So here match access group, suppose just assume that we wrote an access list, access group 100, right? Then exit. Class map called queue. Okay, match access group, not queue, should be anything called file. So we are doing FTP. So I'll write FTP so that you'll understand. So match access group 102. Okay, suppose two I have created. Then I will create a policy map. Policy map called Q. You created the policy map called Q. What you will do here inside this, you will call your class map called web and tell them you belong to bandwidth. CBWFQ I'm assigning you and with %20. Similar way, class called FTP. Bandwidth %30. Right, this is like an example which you are also aware. This much. You have a sign. Now, see, try to understand. Now I'm right, I'm just going to write the second policy map. You cannot apply on the same direction two policy map. So policy map, I'm applying the name called shape. So inside that, I will going to call class default as discussed. Okay, and here, then suppose I will say that shape average, whatever. Okay. Now, what I will do, I will call this policy map called Q inside this shape. So that will be a new command for you, like a parent and child policy we say. So service policy here, I am inside policy map called shape. Here I'm calling Q. Okay, so what it will do now, it will do shaping. When I have explained, you remember, actually in the real time how it works. This is your 10 Mbps. Okay, inside that each queue is saying that 20% of what? 10 Mbps. 30% of what? This is how it works. Okay, then type exit twice. Exit. And then interface F0/0 service policy. You apply outbound, but which one? Only shape. Because inside shape you are calling queue. Now this is very important. This I can ask you. It all depends like if you are writing QS or not in the end. But otherwise it will help you. This is very, very important how actually there you have to configure. Okay, so I'll show you the configuration also so that it will, these things will fix on your mind itself. Now, here only I will going to create, let me check on which router I can create. It's an outbound policy, so we'll do it on R3, we'll overwrite whatever the previous one. I will do one thing. Interface F0/1 share. even required. Just now create an access list for 100, permit a TCP any equal to 80. Then create 103 equal to 21. Okay, and then what will happen, what you have to do is you have to create a class map called web. Okay, match protocol HTTP. What I gave the name, sorry, match access group 100 and come out of this, and then class map called FTP match access group. You can give one more name. You can delete this. You can give five. And match access group called 103. Okay, then create a policy map. Policy map called Q. Enter. Okay, and call here class called class web, and bandwidth you want to give. %20 and class called file. And bandwidth you will give in percent of 30. Okay. And then we have class called class. You can take default also. It's up to you. But not required. Just I have to show you the configuration. Again, one more policy you will going to create, policy map called shape. Okay. Class called class default. Okay, shape average, whatever you want to type. After that, here you have to call that Q service policy called Q. This is called parent and child policy. Exit. Go to interface 0/1 and type service policy output. Shape. Here, so do show history. This is what we did. Alright. Okay. So today we have seen queuing practical. We have seen shaping, policing practical. Okay. So today I'll stop here. Tomorrow, what we will do? Tomorrow we'll start with your concept of congestion avoidance. More theoretical. So complete theoretical. For that, just revise your TCP. If not, then I will just, whatever is required, I can explain you those concepts that time only. But tomorrow we'll start with, it's a small topic. So tomorrow we'll complete the QS. Whatever small things are required, I'll just give you all those things. So this will become your packet level. This will see, this is not in the exam, but it will help you in the production network, in the interviews, all these things, whatever you're learning. Okay, so I'll see you tomorrow.